You ask what you always wanted to know about me, and I answer in my 365 days journal. Hi there, this is Luisa Heinzel. Welcome to my channel, Junk Journal Art. Nice to see you here today for another question and answer round here in my 365 days journal. If you've never heard about this journal, then please check out the playlist down below in the description box. There you can watch what you perhaps have missed. Today, I would like to try to make a spread in my journal here. And I would like to use my favorite song lyrics as a base for my spread. At the same time, I would like to collect other favorite things in this spread, but my base will be the lyrics of my favorite songs. So Sarah has asked me what's my favorite song, and that brought me to the idea to try this here, this little experiment. And perhaps it's an idea for your own junk journal as well. If you ask what can I journal about, then this could be an idea for you perhaps as well. Please feel free to take those questions that my viewers have asked to use them as some kind of a prompt or idea, inspiration in your own junk journals. So I think I will first mention the names of the people who have asked me the questions that I'm trying to answer here today to make sure that I don't forget someone or someone's name. So the questions from today are coming from Studio Lou, Gudrun, Connie, Linda Marie, Tinky, Metz, Catherine, Lucinda, B.A. Robin, Meadowbook Journals, and as I said, Sarah. So I will put all of your questions together a little bit and try to do my thing here today. Okay, so there was this question about my favorite song and my favorite music that brought me to the idea for this spread that I'm trying to do today here in my journal. In one of the last videos within this series, I have talked about my tattoo because you have asked me about that and the meaning behind that. And I have told you something about a band that I have followed for a very long time. But and that's this band, Die Schützenjäger. It's an Austrian band. But that's, of course, not the only music that I like. I would like to start in my childhood because... Yeah, when I was a child, there was a music show in TV, and I have seen a singer there, and I immediately fall in love, not only with his music, but also with him. And this man, he is called Patrick Lindner, and I have to laugh because it's not such a usual thing for a woman with the age of 41, I mean, I'm 41 years old, to hear that kind of music, I think. For the people around me, it's really, really strange that I hear that kind of music. And especially when I was a teenager, I had really much problems with the other children or the other teenagers that went to school with me and that were in the same class as I was. They laughed about me because of that music. But I have to say, from the very first day when I saw Patrick Lindner in the German TV, I was sure that this man is someone who will follow me for a very long time, and he's still in my life, when you can say it like this. I mean, I'm still hearing his music and I'm watching everything that he is publishing on YouTube or in TV or wherever. And very long time ago, and that's the reason why I have taken out this journal, I made this spread. Unfortunately, I have not dated it. I don't know when that was, but I just realized that I have a video about this spread. I can check that out. So perhaps I'm able to find out when I have uploaded the video. So that was approximately the time when I did this here. I have this altered book here. I made that and I made a spread about, yeah, the very first song that I've heard from Patrick Lindner. And that song is called Die kleine Tür zum Paradies. That's a German song. And that means the tiny door to paradise. And it's such a heartwarming song. It's really kitschy when you hear it now. I mean, it's very long time ago that I've heard it the first time. I was a child when I heard that. I think it was, let me check that out, which year it was when I heard that the first time. So I guess this is the first video that was published. And that was 1989. So I was 8 years... my goodness, I can't speak. I was 8 years old when I heard this song for the first time. And I will try to let you hear the music of this song within this video so that you can get, yeah, the feeling for it. But attention, it's a strange song. It's really, really strange. But perhaps you like it as well. So I have made this spread. And then I decided that I want to make a copy of that to use that as some kind of collage material for my spread here today. I didn't want to tear out the pages from my altered book, the original pages, of course. So I decided to make a copy. That's perhaps an idea for you as well. This turned out not so wonderful like the original page, but it's, for me, it's, to have the lyrics, because I have written the lyrics of the song here as well to this page so that I can use them for my new spread. And I had the big luck that I could meet Patrick Lindner 2 times in my life. So the first time, that was 2007. So I have a picture here from him and me. That was a really, really cool story because it was my father's birthday in the year 2007, and my ex-husband and me, we were invited to the birthday party of my father, and at the same date, there was a concert of Patrick Lindner and some other musicians in a concert hall directly next to the house of my father. And I was sitting on this birthday party like, oh, with 1 billion of bees in my trousers. I was like, I want to go there. I had no ticket or something like that. But I knew this concert hall really, really well and the location there because my orchestra and I, we had some events there as well. So I was on the same stage like he was in this evening many, many times in my life. So that was also a really strange feeling that he had his feet on the same stage like I was for so many times with my orchestra. And then suddenly my ex-husband said to me, let's go to the back entrance when the event has its pause. So perhaps we can meet him there. Even if we don't have a ticket, perhaps we can go into this concert hall and perhaps we have luck and we can meet him. And I said, that will not be possible. That's totally strange. We can't do that. But he was so sweet. He was such a sweet man in this moment that he said, come, Luisa, we go there. And then we first tried to go into the main entrance of this concert hall. And there was, this security man. And the strange thing was, I knew who this man was. I mean, I know this man in person. Yeah. And I said to him, it was his job to be the security man in this, on this event. And I said to him, please let me go in. And I could see him sitting there on a chair behind a table and he was writing some signatures for the fans who were there. And I said, I have no ticket. I would only like to go there, ask for a photo and a signature, and then I will go and I will not listen to the music. I will go back to the birthday party of my father. And he was like, no, I have my rules. I can't let you in. So go away. Okay, so I left the concert hall and yeah, I was in front of this hall with tears in my eyes because I had seen him, but I couldn't reach him. And that was really, really strange for me. So then my hubby, or my ex-hubby, said to me, let's go to the back entrance, because when he is finished making his signatures there on those little cards with his photo, then he has to go exactly that way, away from the table and to the area behind the stage. So perhaps we can see him through the glass door that's on the back entrance. We ran there and we have waited there for a few minutes, and then suddenly this moment happened. Here you can see this little, yeah, what is that called? The area between the main building, and here on the left side there's the backstage area of the stage. Was that an English sentence? I don't know. You know what I mean. And suddenly he came here, and he had a flower bouquet in his hands. He got that from one of his fans. And my hubby, so you have to imagine, in front of this door, there's some kind of little way. And then there are some stairs, approximately 6 or 7 stairs. And my hubby was here and he was jumping up to those stairs. Then he took this glass door and he was not sure if this door was open or if it was closed. And he opened this door and Patrick Lindner was like, what's that? He was so shocked because, of course, he was not aware of someone who is coming through this door. And then my ex-hubby told him that I'm a really huge fan and that I couldn't get a ticket and that stuff. And he was like, that's not the problem. Let's make a photo. And then, yeah, we made this photo. I'm really proud of it. And of course, I would like to include that into my journal today. And then many years later, I moved. I mean, I was not in the same city like this story happened. And that was, let me look at my notepad, 2016. So many years later, I had moved to another city, and there was an announcement in the newspaper that there's a concert with different musicians and Patrick Lindner as well. So I jumped into my car, went to this concert, was in love like at the first time, and yeah, I had the chance to meet him a second time. And that's this photo here. As you can see, I've changed my hair a little bit and I went a little bit older, and here as well. But I'm so proud of these both photos. I can't tell you. Yeah. He is not only a really great musician, but he is a great person, a great character for me as well, because when he published his first song and he was successful with this song, he made, of course, several similar songs in the same style and in the same music genre. But time changes, and of course, the things, taste of the people who are hearing his music is changing as well, and the times are changing. Music is not the same over the years, do you know what I mean? And he was able to be the same character over all of those years. I mean, he's on stage for over 30 years and he has never gone. And for me, that is a really, really He is a role model for me. He is following his arc. I don't know the word that I want to say. He has his dreams, of course, and he wants to reach the people with his music. He's always this heartwarming character, and he is... Let me glue those pictures down. I love him. I'm really strange, I know, but I totally love him. There was another question that is really funny for me, because the question is, if I go to a party, if I like to drink wine or beer. So I was like, when do I go to a party? I mean, if I go to a music concert, for example, I have to drive my car, so I'm drinking no alcohol. But of course, I would like to answer that question. And the answer is definitely wine. In some cases, I like to drink beer, but in the most cases, I like to drink wine. So let's check if this wine is good or not. I would say it's okay, but I think the better idea is to take that and splatter a little bit here around to my page to, I want to document this question, of course. Here on my page as well. I don't know if that will be the right color for this page, but why not? Let's see how that looks when it's dry. This is nearly invisible. The splatters are really nice. That matches surprisingly really, really well to this blue and green colors here of these botanicals. I'm a little bit surprised that it's not so visible here, but we both know that it is here. So, yeah, I have my wine here in my journal as well.
Zärtlicher Regen klopft ganz leise an mein Fenster. Zärtlicher Regen, so wie's damals war mit dir. Da war nur die Nacht und du, und die Liebe kam dazu. Mit dir und für immer, sagten wir. Zärtlicher Regen, die Erinnerung hilft mir träumen. Schließ die Augen, spür dich atmen neben mir. Dann sag ich leise, ich liebe dich, doch ich weiß, du hörst es nicht. Vielleicht geht's dir heute Nacht grad so wie mir. Manchmal träum ich noch von dir, wenn es Nacht wird. Manchmal holt mich deine Zärtlichkeit zurück. Ist die stille kleine Sehnsucht, im Herzen bleibt der Rest von einer schönen Zeit. Uns blieb nur unser Traum von Ewigkeit. Zärtlicher Regen und der Nachtwind stellt mir Fragen.
There was another question. What is your favorite flower and why? I thought it would be way easier to answer to such a question because this question seems to be really easy. I mean, what's your favorite flower, Luise? That's not so hard to answer, but it is. My favorite flower is every flower that is painted somewhere. I especially love flowers that are painted with oil paint. So I have no special kind of flower that I like the most, but I like these paintings of flowers. And yeah, every flower that is painted is my favorite flower. That's a little bit strange, I know. A strange answer. I mean, if I'm in nature or, yeah, somewhere where you can see flowers, of course, there are some that I like more than others. But in general, I would say everything that is painted is my favorite. I really like dandelions. Hopefully I'm saying this word right. Or every kind of wildflower is also really, really nice for me. And what I definitely don't like are those flowers that you can get in a bouquet, for example. I mean, those flowers that have been cut to make the bouquet. I don't like that. I always have the feeling when someone is carrying such a bouquet in his hands, it looks like he has some
corpse.
Aha. it feels like, what is the plural of corpse? Leichen. Corpses.
Corpses.
It feels like this person with the flower bouquet has some corpses in his hands. This word feels really strange. Can someone tell me if that's a word that I should put into my vocabulary? Or is that an unusual word? Oh my goodness. Yeah, so another question was, what is your favorite museum? There is no special favorite museum, but I really like all of those old buildings. Even if there's no official museum in them, for me, nearly every old building is a museum for itself. For example, all of the old buildings in Rome are museums for me, even if there's no sign outside here, we are an official museum. And I really, really like to visit those buildings and to learn more about them. One of my really, really fantastic, the most amazing building for me is the Pantheon in Rome. As you perhaps know, I'm a really big fan of the city Rome. There will be a separate video about Rome and all the questions that you have asked me that have to do with this city and with my visits there and that stuff. I can't press that into this video, so there will be a separate video about that. But the Pantheon is my favorite building in Rome, and that's at the same time my favorite museum. I really love to be there.
Manchmal träum ich noch von dir, wenn es Nacht wird. Manchmal holt mich deine Zärtlichkeit zurück. Ist die stille kleine Sehnsucht, die tief im Herzen bleibt, der Rest von einer schönen Zeit. Uns blieb nur unser Traum von Ewigkeit. Manchmal träum ich noch von dir, wenn es Nacht wird. Manchmal holt mich deine Zärtlichkeit zurück.
Okay, so I have chosen the most favorite line of this lyric from this song, Die kleine Tür zum Paradies, The Tiny Door to Paradise. And that is, und ans Glück auf dieser Welt muss man glauben. This is some kind of dialect, not really clear German. But yeah, that says you have to believe in the luck of the world. So that means something like luck will only come to you if you believe in it. In English, that sounds a little bit strange, I know. But in German, it makes so much sense. It makes sense in English as well, but it sounds so heavy in German, even if it's included into this really smooth and lovely song. But for me, it's a really heavy quote, and I like to have that here now. Okay, so this is my page, I would say.
Zärtlicher Regen, die Erinnerung hilft mir träumen. Schließ die Augen, spür dich atmen neben mir. Dann sag ich leise, ich liebe dich. Doch ich weiß, du hörst es nicht. Vielleicht geht's dir heute Nacht grad so wie mir. Manchmal träum ich noch von dir, wenn es Nacht wird. Manchmal holt mich deine Zärtlichkeit zurück. Ist die stille kleine Sehnsucht, die tief im Herzen bleibt, der Rest von einer schönen Zeit.